Do you guys remember prank videos? Like the good pranks, not the scripted weird stuff we've all seen on TikTok. You know what I'm talking about? The half prank, half social experiment videos that kind of just end up upsetting people. These guys, Zach and Jay, are one of the few prank creators left on YouTube that are actually trying to be creative with their videos. They put so much effort into all of their content and risking getting into trouble a lot. But don't worry, they're not like faking bank robberies, Stoke Twins. But some of their pranks do tend to border on being kind of illegal. That said, some of their videos are pretty wild and pretty weird, and more than once, they've ended up in the news, and people have a lot to say about them. The most popular video on their channel, The Zach and Jay Show, is "We Faked a Model to the Top of Fashion Week." They pretty much gave their audience exactly what was in the title. They got their friend and fellow YouTuber Max to pretend to be a model called Maximus Bucharest, dressed him up in a ridiculous, cheaply made outfit, and tried to get him into London Fashion Week. It's kind of crazy how easy it was for them to pull this off, like worryingly easy. All Max had to do was pose outside the venue in his wild outfit, and he was hounded by photographers who legit believed he was there as a model for a designer. He managed to get inside the venue without any kind of effort. I don't know about y'all, but I can definitely smell something fishy here. Like perhaps maybe they had some sort of inner shady business to get him in and they were just faking it. While he was literally on the inside, he got to rub shoulders with the rich and famous, who had no idea he wasn't a real model. It helped that Max is a pretty good actor, but he got super invested in his model character. Even though this video was super funny, it had the unexpected effect of highlighting how little security there was at this event. If Max could just walk in, if of course he did walk in without any sort of prior connection and that also so easily, so could anyone, right? Fashion Week is always a huge event. If somebody dangerous decided to do what these guys did, then it could put a lot of lives at risk. This was noted by a couple of people in the comments who pointed out that the video proves just how gullible and easily misled some people are. Others said that in actuality, Zach and Jay didn't really fake anything. They got a guy, dressed him up, and sent him to a fashion event. Isn't that basically the reality of modeling and the fashion industry? What's pretty weird is there were seemingly no negative consequences to this video, at least for Zach, Jay, and Max. They went on to recreate this video twice more, once again with Max, and another with an older lady who totally killed it as a model, by the way. And even though that video is their most popular, it is not their wildest prank or experiment. In one video, they managed to sneak their way onto a red carpet event to hopefully try and surprise Leonardo DiCaprio with the bear from The Revenant, which was just Jay wearing a bear mask. Even though they didn't manage to totally pull off the prank and almost got security called on them, they shocked their viewers with their bravery and commitment to their pranks. I mean, these guys hid in a bathroom at the movies for 3 hours to try and pull this thing off. Plus, they once again highlighted how high-profile events like these have way more lax security than they appear. Sure, they were asked a couple of times why they were at the event, but they were literally able to lie their way out of getting caught without having to show any credentials. Even though they didn't get to meet Leo, their fans were super supportive in the comments and gave them kudos for even trying. But it still makes me wonder, like, this can go so wrong. In a video they posted in early 2021, they projected some pretty soul-crushing messages from the British public to Prime Minister Boris Johnson onto the Houses of Parliament. I don't know what a wet wipe is, but I know I don't want to be one. Most of the other messages were pretty, let's say, vocal about their dislike towards Boris. You'll see what I'm talking about if you check out the video. Although most of the viewers took this video for what it was, a comedic prank, some people were super offended by the messages sent to Boris. They called the prank immature and complained that what they did was technically illegal. Because after all, he is the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, and what they did could be considered slandering, and they could face serious charges for it. But luckily, for the most part, people saw the funny side, even some of Boris's supporters and the media, who reported pretty widely on what Zach and Jay did. In one of their more obscure videos, they broke a world record when they spent 24 hours on the London Underground, which isn't known to be the nicest place to spend the night with the amount of pollution and critters that live in the trains, and I don't even want to get into the details of it, because it involves a lot of bacteria, pollution, and other stuff, and I feel like I need Purell just talking about it. But these guys haven't been super popular with their fans, and for a pretty good reason. In May 2021, they announced the trailer for a docuseries and their most ambitious project ever, sneaking into the royal wedding of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. It got a lot of people talking about it, and a lot of their fans were super excited for its release. Sounds pretty amazing, right? Well, the announcement of the series did not get the hype they expected, and things went so wrong. They had to make an apology video. The idea was to release the docuseries when their main channel hit 1 million subscribers, and by that point, they had just over 800K. So why announce the series before hitting a million? Well, they wanted their fans to help them in that final push to their goal. If you could get 5 of your friends to subscribe to their channel with a unique referral code on their website, only then would you be able to view their docuseries. People were mad about this. Zach and Jay had never pulled this kind of stunt before, and it came as a surprise to people who've watched their videos for a long time. The issue people had is that they were basically being used as free advertisements for the channel, and a lot of subscribers didn't have 5 people they could send the referral code to. It just kind of seems unfair to hype up this project these guys worked so hard on, only to pretty much put it behind a paywall. Plus, as a lot of commenters pointed out, the docuseries probably would have gone viral and got them to a million subs anyway. The situation didn't really get any better when they posted their apology video. This video was met with some backlash too, because, well, there really wasn't much of an apology in there. Even though the guys said they made a mistake, they totally missed the mark. They made it out like people were mad about the series and not the thing with the subscribers. Because of the backlash, they decided to just not release the series, even though everybody in the comments said they still wanted to see it. A lot of commenters felt guilt-tripped by the apology video that Zach and Jay were basically punishing their fans for not going along with the refer to unlock idea. This was only solidified by the fact that they still haven't released the series. People are starting to think that the Royal Wedding docuseries doesn't even exist, and they just did it for more publicity, or they did this to delay posting it because it's not ready to be released. Previously, they'd stated that they hadn't been able to post the video after the Royal Wedding for legal reasons. Maybe those same reasons were stopping them again? Still, I feel like maybe they should have made sure they got the all clear before even teasing the video if that's the case. Or at least they should have been more honest with their subscribers. But what do you guys think? Do you think they'll ever post it? Do you believe that Zach and Jay's weird and controversial videos will land them in big trouble? And what'd you think of my British accent earlier? It was pretty good, right? Let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It's pretty good, right?